Hello, Wareframe, this is James Videos, and today is a very special day, and that is because today is the first build day of Nightmare House 2019, The Dark Harvest. It's September 30th, 2019, and it is the first build day of this year's haunt. Anyways, I've done this video 3 times already. This is my 3rd time, this intro to the video, because I kept planning on building for 3 days now, and then it never happened. But today, it's actually going to officially happen. So, let me just start off here by saying, as you guys know, the haunt theme this year is a farm theme, and it's way different than anything I've ever done before. As you guys know, 2017, 2018, I did a pirate theme and a hell theme. 2012 through 2016, it was just a bunch of random themes. The pirate theme and hell theme, the majority of the scenes had to do with the themes, but there were also some of them that were like clowns and all sorts of stuff that didn't have to do with it, so I've always used all my props. This year it's very different. I'm doing one cohesive theme. It's just a farm theme from start to finish. The haunt's going to be a farm theme, and I'm really excited to do it this way. I really am, because I wanted to do this for a while, and as you guys know, I've moved houses, so now is my chance to do this. Super excited. So I'm only going to be using props that fit the theme and stuff, but I'm starting out outside just so you can show I can show you how the display is going to work first. Also, something new with these haunt build videos, I'm going to be recording throughout the day as progress is done, because people have complained in the past about me recording only at night and it's harder to see things. I'm going to be recording throughout the day as progress is done, that way you can see stuff better and see as stuff is getting done. Anyways, let me start here. The outside of the haunt, this whole yard, of course my house is decorated for Halloween because tomorrow is October 1st. I'm super excited. The outside is going to be displays. Since I'm only doing a farm theme this year and only using props that go with the theme, I definitely still want to use some of my other props though, like some of the really cool ones. So I'm just going to set up little displays outside the house that are going to do with the other props. So first there's going to be a cemetery here. Of course it's already started, but there's going to be animatronic cemetery props there. Right here's going to be clowns. Maybe this might actually change to medieval and clowns over there. Actually, yeah, that's probably what I'm gonna do. So this is gonna be medieval. Over there is gonna be clowns behind the car. This is gonna be hell, pirates, haunted mansion in the doorway, laboratory in the window, and maybe man-eating plants where the vines are. I don't know yet. But anyways, that is the plan for that. Of course, that's not an actual haunt thing. It's just displays that I want to do outside the haunt to kind of drag people in, get people to come to the haunt, because if they see a bunch of props, they'll definitely be a lot more interested and want to stop by your house and maybe go in the haunt. Now I'm going to start the haunt plans. Since I haven't done a layout yet this year, since I'm starting the build today, I'm going to do the layout today too. So first off, the entrance to the haunt is going to be a big barn here. It's going to be a big barn facade made entirely out of wood, attached onto the garage with some corn stalks and stuff out there. And Mac gave me this idea to put a hangman hanging from that tree, because that tree does look like a tree that you'd find in farmland. So I think that's going to work really well, and people will see it as they're walking up to the haunt, and it will definitely be very uncanny thinking that they're going to have to walk through there soon and just wondering what could be going on in there. Anyways, guess we'll walk through the garage, because it's my first year having a house with a garage, so I'm super excited to have that. I think it's going to look really cool. It's going to be the barn, and guess we'll walk through that. And I'm not going to go in right now because it's filled up with stuff. It will be cleaned out and decorated for the haunt, of course, but guess we'll walk through this door and into the field of screams. So this is going to be the cornfield. Avery is like 70% chance coming down to the haunt this year and playing Jackson's girlfriend, Missy. I am going to upload a video the day before or on Halloween of the haunt's backstory this year, so you'll understand it before the haunt. So for anyone who's coming to the haunt in person, you'll understand the backstory if you watch the movie and then come to the haunt later that night. And for the rest of you, you'll understand the backstory and then see the haunt video the day after Halloween. But anyways, Avery's going to be here playing Missy, Jackson's girlfriend. She's a scarecrow, so she's going to be there. I'm going to have a bunch of corn stalks in here. I actually bought some corn stalks yesterday for that, and I'll show them to you in a minute. But Looming Strawman is going to be in here. Cornstalker is going to be at the very exit. I'm going to make a lot of scarecrows for this just so I can have some extra in here. Right here is going to be the farmhouse, and this isn't actually going to be a walk-in theme. Guests are just going to walk past the big facade. It's going to have hay bale popper and swinging scarecrow on the porch probably. And my dad's going to jump out and say, get off my property. Over here is the Rector Farm. Since Jackson's last name is Rector, there you've got that tree. So the Rector Farm is going to be like the main section of the farm. There's going to be the windmill, the water tower, the outhouse. all of that stuff. And I'm definitely probably going to use these posts to hang bodies off of or something. Nightmare Harvester is going to go there. Jack Straw and Forgotten Farmer are going to go in here somewhere. Not entirely sure where they're all going to go yet. All I know is that Nightmare Harvester is going in the corner. And remember, there are going to be walls separating the main sections. So there is separation. Right here, either on this side or on this side, is going to be the Hillbilly's hideout, the kind of shack that the Hillbilly family, who's cooking people, of kind of hiding out on the farmland are. So Rusty's going to be on the porch, some cooked body parts. I'm going to get some fog scents this year that smell like farmland manure and stuff. I just want to mention that. Then there's going to be a facade here for Simon Slaughterhouse, the butcher who lives on the farm, and his shop is on the farm. So people will walk in. It will be a rustic butcher shop, not like a modern type one. And then this will be incorporated into the theme. This will be an indoor section, so there will be a roof, but this will be incorporated in. This is going to be the back room. So you're just going to be able to see that from inside the slaughterhouse, and it will look like the walls are going to be attached to that, so it will just look like another room inside the slaughterhouse. So that'll be the back room where they chop up the corpses. Right here is the Forest of Lost Souls, and this is supposed to be the forest surrounding the farmland. So you're going to have Limripper, Forest Demon in here probably, other forest props, and Smoldering Zombie in the fire pit. Then guests will walk around here, and you've got the Dead Oaks Cabin, which is going to be the cabin on the farmland where people can stay the night, and obviously they're going to get killed by Jackson. It's going to have taxidermy, real dead animals. It's going to be pretty cool. And then guests will walk here, and this was originally going to be the Wild West part of the haunt, because I thought, oh, it'll work. Wild West kind of works well with the farm theme, because they're both in the country, they're both in the south. Well, the west is out west, but a lot of it is in the south as well. So I thought, oh, it's going to work. But I decided not to do that, because I feel like it would be better to just have the entire haunt be farm. I was originally going to have it farm and the surrounding area, but I decided to just do farm. So Deadwood, the saloon, the ghost train, and Deadwood Mines are all being cut out, and this is just going to be one scene. This is going to be the sawmill. So guests will walk in, there will be like spinning saws and stuff, chopped up body parts, maybe tortured torso if I get him for it. I'm not a big fan of tortured torso, but I might get him specifically for the scene. Guests will walk out there. This was originally going to be the bayou, because it is supposed to be a farm located in Louisiana. So I wanted some kind of tie in there to show people that it's supposed to be in Louisiana. I decided to take that out because that was the only reason for it, is to really convey that it's supposed to be in Louisiana so people know where they are. But I feel like it would be a lot better to just have it be taken out, because it would take away from the whole farm feel. Yes, it still works a little bit because it's still southern, but it would take away from the whole farm feel. So I'm just going to have this be an extension of the pumpkin patch. This will be the weighing and checkout station for the pumpkins. And then guests will walk this way, and then this will be the rest of the pumpkin patch. Tons of pumpkins and stuff, tons of vines. Pumpkin patch prowler is going to be in here, and at the very exit will be towering Jack-O-Man. So there you have that, and I'll show you this prop that I was working on. Finished yet. He doesn't look too great yet because he doesn't have all of the paint on him yet, but he's this big pumpkin creature I made for the pumpkin patch. He's just going to be in the background, so he doesn't need to look too great anyways, and he's very skinny because I want him to be like that, to look like a, he's made out of stems, but he's going to be spray painted green, so he definitely will look better once he is completed. But I just took some PVC pipes and great stuff and the pumpkin head from Party City a couple years back. Here's a bunch of supplies, boards and all sorts of stuff. The facades are going to be made out of beams, some clothes for scarecrow props, and then over here are the corn stalks. And these are very, very large corn stalks. They're about 10 feet tall, I'd say. So they're huge. I've never had corn stalks this big, but I was lucky enough to find some this big, and I definitely got a lot more corn stalks than I usually get. I think it was like almost $50 worth of corn stalks here. And so I got a ton of them because I obviously need them since I'm doing a farm theme. So, and I'm super excited to be doing a farm theme because it's definitely my second favorite Halloween theme. It's Pennywise. That is so weird. A red balloon just flying out of nowhere. Oh, that's weird. I swear, Pennywise is here. What in the world? I mean, yeah, I know balloons go off sometimes, but what a coincidence. While I'm making a video about the haunt, a red balloon just comes flying out of nowhere. That is weird. That is really weird. It's Pennywise. Anyways, I'm super excited to be doing a farm theme because farm is definitely my second favorite theme for Halloween next to hell. So I wanted to do a farm theme for a while. So we'll see where this takes us and we'll see what we get done today. Okay, so it's nighttime because most of the time that things were getting done today, my parents were doing it and I was at the store getting more supplies. Anyways, this is what my parents did when I was at the store. Hold on. They started this. This is going to be the hillbilly's hideout. I don't know what this is. I think this is for the roof. I think that's what they have for that. I don't know. But they started the hillbilly's hideout, and I know it's cardboard, but that is because I want to save the wood pieces, because wood is expensive. I want to save the wood pieces for the farmhouse and stuff, and the hillbilly's hideout is a smaller piece, so it doesn't need to be as good. But yes, it looks stupid right now, but that's because it hasn't had the paint job yet. My mom is an artist. She's done murals for places all over the city and stuff, so she is going to paint this and make it look really nice. That paint looks kind of weird, but that's because that's the basic coating done. She still has a lot more to do. That's just the basic to show where the lines are going to go. But this is made with wood and cardboard. So the front is cardboard. Like I said, I'm saving the wood for the bigger pieces. Of course, they aren't all going to be cardboard. It's not going to look crappy. Even this one that is cardboard is not going to look crappy. It's going to have a porch made out of wood. There's going to be beams. There's going to be a roof and everything. It's going to look good once it's done because it's not all cardboard. Just this main part is cardboard here. There's window outline and stuff. And if you could see, there's beams on the undersides. Those are the supports that are going to hold it up. So it is wooden cardboard. Just the facade part is cardboard. Because like I said, I'm saving the big wooden parts for the farmhouse, the barn, stuff like that. Stuff that really, really needs it. So, yeah, that's that. And it's not too much done today, but at least construction has started. And there will definitely be a whole lot more done tomorrow. We started kind of late today, so that's the whole thing with that. But I'm going to show you guys what I got at the store. New supplies. So, you can see I got a bunch of stuff. I got a bunch of spray paint. I got some white right here. Got some black. Here's rust to make stuff look rusted. Some more whites and blacks, because you always need those for coating and stuff. Some staples, blade for a cutting knife. We've got a hot glue gun. This is all kind of the boring stuff. Paint rollers for painting stuff. Some glue sticks. And more paint. I got some green for pumpkin stems and stuff. And some glossy red for blood. And I'll get to the more exciting stuff in a second. Starting now, I got some flame lights for $3 each. So there's also tape in there. I got these flame bulbs for $3 each. I put those in lanterns and stuff. And then I've also got, I got these, I didn't really want these, but my grandma wanted to get them. She kind of made me. She was like, no, you need these. But, yeah, they're going to be useful. They're still going to be, because what we're going to do with these, and I'm actually kind of glad we got them because they are cheap.
Put this somewhere and save it because I'm going to wear that Halloween.
They are kind of cheap. They're only a dollar each. And what we're going to do, going to cut off this, of course. Cover the top. Going to cover it with something orange to make it look like a full pumpkin. And then do a better paint job on this. Paint in between the cracks, make it look better. And add maybe great stuff for vines. I'm definitely going to do a lot of work on these to make these look better. But the reason we got these is because the pumpkin patch needs a lot of pumpkins. And if we were to buy a bunch of expensive pumpkins, that would not, we would not have enough money for how many I need. So we just got four of these, just for a few that are going to be in the background. I think they'll look good once they're done. Right now they just look like pumpkin pails, of course, but they will look a lot better once they have better paint jobs and they're all working right. They're sparky. And then I got this actual pumpkin because I want some that are already made. I might do a better paint job on it, but it does look pretty good. And then I got some real pumpkins, because I want some just normal pumpkins that are not carved or anything, so I did get some real pumpkins too. So that's all the work that was done today. Tomorrow, I know what I'm going to do is we're going to work a little bit more on the Hillbilly's Hideout, and I'm going to work on this guy. So I'm going, and I might start another prop. I don't know yet. But the Hillbilly's Hideout is like main priority right now to get that done so we can move on to another facade after that one. So the Hillbilly's Hideout is there, and then I'm going to finish this guy tomorrow by finally painting him. And because he's been sitting like this for a couple days now, so I'm finally going to paint him tomorrow and get him finished. Anyways, I hope you all enjoyed this this build video. Not very much was done today, but that's only because it was the first day. Usually, as we get closer to Halloween, more is done. Oh, I forgot to show this pumpkin patch, mash jack-o'-lantern metal sign. I'm going to put it on the pumpkin weighing station. There's actually another pumpkin patch sign that's at Walmart, but it was sold out. Hopefully they'll get some more in stock before Halloween that actually says pumpkin patch. But this one says fresh from the patch, Halloween brand, mashed jack-o'-lantern, perfect for pies. I feel like this would be nice to have on the pumpkin patch weighing station as like a sign for mashed pumpkins that they're making. I think that'd be pretty cool. Anyways, that's everything that was done today. Like I said, not too much, but things will definitely start amping up as we get closer to Halloween. I'm just glad that we got a good start. Hope you all enjoyed. Keep an eye on the moon, my werewolves.
Subscribe to Jaden's videos and join the werewolf army. I'll let you live another day, but it's not guaranteed.